Hi, Ivy. Let's go over your rough draft. I'll send you some screenshots of this because sometimes y'all can open the comment section from your computers and sometimes you can't. So you'll have both the screenshots and this video that will help you. All right, so looking at the first page, let me make this a little bit smaller. I may have to make it bigger here in a little bit, but looking at the first page, I'm gonna make it a little bigger so I can read it. Put a border around the entire image. You can stretch the image vertically because it's a little fat, so stretch it up and down. And provide the URL that you got it from underneath the image. By the way, this picture is outdated, so get one at least 2021. Yeah, this is what, 11 years ago? Way outdated. Do not put anything. I wouldn't go back further than a year if you're going to use graphics. Now, in your, I still wouldn't even use something this old in your statistics, in your paragraphs either. So I would change this. And because it's got a white background, I probably would give it a black border. So you should be able to go click on that image and go to format picture. Yours might look different. I mean, you can make it whatever color you want, but I'm going to put a solid line and probably black would be the best and just leave it where it's a very thin line. Okay. So just a suggestion. All right. Now down here, put your IV, but you also need to put my name there too. So you should have my name. Then you need to put the section number. And I think if you look at the sample that I provided, I think in last week's lesson, that will help you. But you should know what your section number is. Okay, now this has kind of gone to the next page. So let's bring it back up. And it doesn't like that. Well, that's no problem. Let's just take this in a little more, make the picture a little smaller. Oops. Okay. And make sure it's still centered. All right. Now, problem overview, you need to put that on the next page. But here we go here. So I would probably, even though you have to write this in Times New Roman on the cover page, you can actually make it bigger if you want to. So there's 16 right there. You need to put your section number there. Okay, that's the title page. Going to the next one. In the problem overview, go back and look at the direction. You're supposed to have three different quotations from three different sources. You only have two, so you need to find another one. Let's go to, yeah, I'm telling you, problems overview goes to the top. You've got several problems with your in-text citations. Please go over these. You really shouldn't be having these problems at this point. You make a comment over here that I'm asking you or telling you you need to back up with support. Prove this support from a credible source. And I think that you're talking about pregnancies from a long time ago, and you just talk in generalities. That I could just pull that out of a hat. I don't know that that's just something you're speculating on, but you need to give support from a credible source to back you up on that. I can't just take your word for it. Okay, then here I would omit this. You said far more acceptable within households. I don't know if acceptable is even a good choice of words. I don't think that the majority of families find it. I mean, it's a debatable, it's a moot point. And nobody's going to win the argument, but I don't know that people accept a teenage pregnancy. Some do, some don't. But let's just take that out. Then here, again, you have a problem after you have your quotation. You need to put a space, the author's name, and then that's it. Okay, so correct the in-text citation. You should have a period after this. If that's the end, let me see. Yeah, period should go there. Oh, I don't want, doesn't want me to do it. Okay. Oh, it wants me to put edit. All right. So be sure that you put, where did it go? Period. After the last parenthesis. And then a space. It's really need to get some new reader glasses or at least put them on. Okay, there should be a space between the period and the T on the. Okay, on this one, I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger. Okay, this is on the second page, and it really, I don't know, I just now noticed this, but remember when you go up here, you go to insert, and you don't go to header, you go to page number, and that's where you put page number, you make sure it's in the right, it's at the top. I guess someone is there. Okay, say okay. Take this out. Okay, now put your last name. You probably take out some of these spaces. Well, let me go back. Okay, then what I would do is I would do it now where you highlight this and you go to your home screen, you go to Times New Roman 12 and make sure that that's uniform. Now, when you do this, it will do the page numbers for you. So see the next one's 2, the next one's 3, but if you go to insert header, it's not, it's going to be all page 1. And that's kind of silly thing to be counted off on when you can go back and do it right. Okay. So I've gone over the problem overview. Let's go to the third page. Somewhere you must mention figure 1 and how it fits into the context of the paragraph. Be sure to tell the reader where to find figure 1 after you've chosen a permanent location for it. For example, you could say it's on the next page, bottom of page, top of page, and the same applies to figure 2. So if this figure here has something to do with what you wrote on the previous page, then you would say figure 1 on the next page, okay? If it this has something to do with it, what is in this paragraph, then you would say figure one above shows. Now I say find a permanent place because you'll be revising and editing and the picture may go up or it may go down to the next page. Just find a permanent spot. And then at the very, toward the very end of turning it in, make sure that your final rough draft, that you have it where you want it, and that you tell us where to find the figures, and then make sure then you save it. Okay, so you have to mention where the figure is. Okay, so let's see, this goes to the top. This goes to the top. Oh, stretch the image horizontally down. This is side to side with the caption. Include the source or the URL or author. Now you may have gotten it from, if you would have gotten this from one of your citations that's on your works cited, then you would have put it at the end. Okay, so let's say it's Horner, but you don't have a Horner. I'm just saying that. Okay. Now, make sure that you have four lines here and just four lines. Okay. And that you have four lines between the caption and the next paragraph. Correct this. In-text citation is incorrectly formatted and has no page number, and it should, because you do have page number and a period goes after that. Let's see. On the next one, this is the big question because it does make a difference who your audience is, because then you might approach that audience differently than you would another. So who is your audience? It's not clear. Also, this is way too wordy. You've been using a lot of words when it could, you could use half the amount of words and still get the message across. So make sure that you say that to the people who are editing and revising your work. But first you need to go clean it up to make it easier for them. So I was saying the first two sentences could be more concise. If you put them together, let me see. Well, I didn't write it down there. There is not one or enough solutions to fully prevent teenagers getting pregnant from happening. There are two prominent and realistic solutions to this recurring issue. Well, I agree that you, but again, who's going to solve this? Who's going to alleviate this, the problem? So obviously I'm going to make sure. I don't think I have put it there. It looks like I tried to do that, but it won't let me. So I would, you could put these together in a sentence. Just saying, preventing teenagers from getting pregnant, preventing teenage girls from getting pregnant is a I wrote it down and I don't have it now. Just say, let me think it off the top of my, how did I put it? If not the most, I think I started with, if not the most Okay, teen pregnancy, if not the most, because it, if not the most difficult epidemic taking place. Let me see if I can write this down. Maybe if I did it like this, I can do it. Okay, well, are you going to let me edit it? Hold on. Apparently, I did not save one of these, and I'm trying to find it. Well, I guess I'm not going to. Okay, so okay, I paused this for just a moment so that I could go and write what I had before. Actually, I think this is better. I would take out this part, so I'm going to put a cross through on it and start with something like this. Teen pregnancy is something that will probably be a growing issue in the United States, especially if one eye, the far right politicians have, the far right politicians abolish abortion altogether. As with anything else, the best solution is prevention. Mandating sex education, and I put from a scientific point of view, in high schools is one way that will help, and providing free, easily accessible contraceptives to teens is another. You know, boys get condoms if girls need to. Girls should be counseled, though, on taking estrogen, because I don't know if this is bad now, but some have gotten breast cancer that has been tied back to high estrogen from the birth control pills. And I just want to put an aside here. I think right now that girls can get free contraceptives from Planned Parenthood. I could be wrong. I'm not sure. I think somebody did something on this before, but I, if I'm right, you don't have to be 18 and you don't need parental consent. I don't know. I could be totally wrong. Or maybe that's going, you might look at Planned Parenthood and ask the question on Google, does Planned Parenthood give free contraceptives to teens without their parents' knowledge? Okay. But that's the big one there. If they don't have to do that to let the parents know, then that might help. Okay, I went ahead and took this part out. You can leave the rest of it in. Okay, so, all right. Again, we need to know who the audience is. I think I addressed that at the end. Well, you know that them just has one T. Okay. Benefits of solutions. Okay, that was in the solutions. Benefits of solutions. Okay, you put the person's last name there, which is Livingston. Okay, work cited. Okay, that, yeah, totally not right. Okay, I said I've written so many comments, you may have trouble reading them. That's why I'm writing this addendum and commenting on each section. Okay, cover page. If you use that image with the date on it, it cannot be. So if you use any image and it's got a date, it can't be any older than 2021. Write the URL below the image. In your problem overview, and I put it in a black box up there beside problem overview, you should have three different quotations from three different sources in it. You only have two. Get another one. You make many unsubstantiated sentences. This is what I was telling you earlier. You're saying a lot of things, but you have no proof. When I say, where is your proof? I'm asking, who's the expert that you're quoting or that you're paraphrasing? You said the number of teenage pregnancies in America is significant each year, as the statistics have shown and proven. Therefore, many United States citizens, especially parents of high school students, are interested in a way to decrease the rate of teen pregnancies today. But then you don't back that up. How do we know that? Is that speculation? Well, okay, but and that's okay, but you need to put in someone to back that up. How do we know that? Same thing here. You said children or something, or teens age 15 through 19. Well, we know that it's just the girls getting pregnant, usually. And I mean, yeah, I'm going to leave it at that. So just take, oh yeah, you did say girls. That's what I wanted you to do. Take girls out, because we know that it's girls you're talking about in high school. So 15 to 19. You said, and this is something that got me really, I didn't really know what you were saying. Prove this with support. Okay. And then correcting your inset text citations. Although teen pregnancy was far more acceptable within households many years ago, it has now become looked down on and unsafe for young girls to become parents at such a young age. Years ago, it was common for girls to marry young and therefore get pregnant exceptionally young. Where is your proof? Where is the statistics? Because I totally disagree with that. I think it's more acceptable now than it was when I was growing up. When I was growing up, and in the 60s and 70s, what would happen is the girl would go visit an aunt in some other state. That was always the case, or her grandparents. And she would disappear for about a year and then come back and everything was Jake. That's now girls are just having them at home. Some giving them up, some are not giving them up. So I would disagree with you on that unless you can provide statistics to back it up. And you said years ago it was common for girls to get married young. Well, yeah, younger. A lot of women didn't get married till they graduated from college. That was around 21. Now women are waiting until their 30s or 40s to get married for the first time. So that, I don't know that I agree with that. And what do you mean by young? My grandmother, who was born in 1894, got married at 17 and had a baby when she was barely 18. She was married. It was the first of four children. And yeah, that's true in the early 1900s, probably. But there were also women who waited and went to college first. So anyway, all of that speculation until you can back that up with proof, with evidence from a source. Right here, you said, you started talking about the 50s and the 60s, and the president at the time, Bill Clinton. Guess what? Bill Clinton was not the president in that year. In fact, Bill Clinton was not old enough to be the president in the 50s. He probably was 15, maybe. I don't know. And see, that tells me you didn't do your research. I mean, it just didn't. And so, again, I ask you, where's your proof? Where is the source? Like I said, that's yeah, check your history book. Find out when Clinton was there. You're about 30 years off. Okay. You seem to be bouncing ideas off the top of your head. That's what I was just saying. You haven't really researched it. how do we, okay, so I said correct the in-text citation. Says the extent of this issue is still increasing as the number has decreased since the 1950s and 60s. Okay, high school students do not always have the mature capability. Or why don't you just say the maturity? See, that's what I'm saying. Be more concise. Use fewer words. While American teen pregnancy rate has steadily decreased since 1990, the question at the core of the dilemma remains, how do we help teen mothers become successful parents, reach their personal goals, and achieve self-efficacy? Okay, so yeah, you need to put that in a correct format. And be sure to put a period there. So let's see. Omit the comma after childbirths. I've highlighted a green statement that is changing the subject. You're not talking about prevention, but helping, yeah, teen mothers cope. But this is more about, okay, they don't have the maturity to raise a child, but that's not, we're talking about not helping them cope. We're talking about prevention before that little fetus even starts forming. So don't get off the topic because you're almost getting into the teen mother thing there. On your solution, cite more examples from credible sources, which I've got, because it's obvious you're just saying things and not really looking them up. Who's your audience? Again, that's going to determine how you word things and what you're going to come up with as solutions. Way too wordy. Get people to work with you from your group on that. Okay, so what I did, and I tried to... Okay, I think that's the one that I did for you up at the top. Oh, yeah. Actually, you said there's not one. This is where I said it. And then I also wrote one in the side comments. To be sure, teenage pregnancy are not likely to go away. Anyway, do a hybrid or something, but you need to rephrase that. Okay, then your benefits, acquire, you need to go do a spell check on this. Omit a comma there. Also, you need to put a transition in. Beside approaching sex education from a biological perspective, another way is, okay, so let's see. I would take out a benefit of and put free birth control. Like I said, if you can get it free, that's the best way to do it. Forget about having to spend your babysitting money to get it. Okay, so cross all that out. And your conclusion again, who's your audience? Are you writing to all public and private schools? If that's what you're thinking of, it's not going to work. Heck, I mean, you could go to Richardson ISD to the superintendent, and the superintendent may make it a decision high school by high school. If you go to like Highlands, you're not mandated to have these. If you go to Berkner, you are. If you go to Richardson High School, I don't know. You might want to present it to the principal of Lake Highlands High School. And keep in mind in your wording, you're talking to the guy who is over your school, who has the authority to do something about it. I probably would use that person anyway, because that person then can take your proposal to the superintendent if need be. Okay. And give them an idea of when this should be accomplished by. Are you talking about the 2022, 2023 school year? Are you going to be able to use science teachers? Maybe if you look at other articles that may talk about what people are doing in their high schools, it could be in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, but what are they doing? Who is teaching these classes? And do Planned Parenthood, does Planned Parenthood have liaisons with a person that a teen would contact? I don't know. See, these are things that you find out through your research. You might want to go to Planned Parenthood. It's probably plannedparenthood.org. I don't know, but look at their website. You could actually use that as one of your sources. Let me look. I went to the Planned Parenthood website, plannedparenthood.org. You can definitely use that. Let's say that you are a student who lives in Richardson. I know there's 75081 and 082. Let's put 081 and see what they will help us with. Okay, so there's a Plano Health Center. So I might want to put 08. Okay, these are people who you can contact that are close by. Okay, so I would think you have one in Richardson. I'm going to go 75080. So this might not help you in your research. I'm just saying if somebody needs it. Yeah. I think they're the same ones. Okay, so let's go back. Let's go to learn abortion, birth control. Let's click on birth control. Let's see if there's anything about look, four teens. Going to the doctor, relationships, sexual orientation videos. Okay, find birth control. Which control is right for me? Okay, so they take a quiz. Okay, so you could do that. I don't know. Let's just say I'm Hispanic. I live in 75080. Net. Oh, why are you asking? Okay. Do I have to write something, I guess? I don't know. Why are you asking? Well, it's like I'm supposed to put something there. Will you? I don't know. Well, anyway, you take this quiz and all that. So I'm sorry. Let's see. Let's say I'm 16. That's what it is. Okay, then I'm going to say, why am I? Okay. What did I not do? Okay, I got that. I got this. So what is this saying to me? You have not answered all required fields. Well, I'm trying to answer this one, but you won't let me. How old are you? Okay, 16. I'll say I'm 17. It doesn't matter. Well, anyway, you fill that out, and I'm just curious to know. If it won't let me fill this part out here, here we go. Birth control method. What's important? That it's easy to keep private, best at preventing, easy to use, easy to get. Uh, prevents STDs. Nobody wants that. Okay, go to next. What's important? I told them. So they're saying I probably have too many things. Wait. I'm sorry, my eyes are just horrid. Please select between 3 and 5. Okay, well, let's say that. Okay, let's say that. I'm just saying. Okay, now, come on. Okay, here we go. How important is best at preventing pregnancy? Extremely important. Easy to keep, quite important. How easy to get? Extremely important. Prevents extremely. So those should be all extremely, I think. Okay, so you go on through it. Do you have health insurance? Or are you willing to pay? I'm going to say no, because I'm going to play like I'm trying to get it without my mother knowing it. Are you willing to use something that has hormones? So I'm going to say no. I would definitely have to go to my doctor. I don't think you ought to do that without a doctor. Are you willing to use a method that you have to put in your vagina? Yes. Are you in a serious romantic? I'll say yeah. Which methods have you heard of? IUD. That's where the doctor actually puts it in there. Condom. I don't know what is a plastic pouch. I've never heard of it, but there you go. Okay, so, all right, so it goes on. I'm so sorry, I so digress. So let me stop that. What I'm wondering though, okay, so I actually went back to the original Planned Parenthood website, and I, let me go back one more. I went ahead this time. I put down learn, and I put sex, I think. Sex, pleasure, discomfort, sex, no. Although some people, I didn't even know all this was on here, so I'm getting an education myself. But check this page and see if there's something that you might be able to find. And it could give you statistics even. Ask the experts. Okay. And I mean, you might be able to do this. I can help you. You could go to Noodle Tools and actually enter in all the information. Like if I wanted to click on this, you could use this. It would be, is abortion still legal? It would be from the website Planned Parenthood, whatever. You go ahead and copy that link up here and paste it there too. But you could use this and speak factually about it. So can I come if I don't have that? Okay, is abortion still illegal? Or is it still legal? Yes, it is. Federally, it is. Can men go? I mean, men need to figure out what they could do. Have to come with, okay, to get an abortion. Well, I don't know about that. I would want to know to get birth control. Okay, so there you go. You might want to check that just to make sure that there's not information that's valuable that you're missing out on. Okay, so here we are back at the end. Be sure what I did, everything that's in red, I put there. Let's see. I'm going to put a period there. So I added some things to make it better. But you still need to go back and you need to get some more statistics that you can use in your solution, possibly even in your problem overview. Because the problem overview, remember, you need to have three sources, three different quotations, and you need to make sure that it adds to the problem overview. So you might be able to find something from Planned Parenthood that might, in the search box you might, or where it says ask, just put statistics and see if it'll pull something up, and you might be able to use something from that to use here. Now you could also, as long as it's not the Furstenberg or the other one that you had, let me see which one that was, Gilbert. You, any other one in your works cited you can use. Now you need to get with somebody, this is all in italics, this totally is not right. You need to set this up on Noodle Tools. Noodle Tools, you put in the information or paste the information in, it does it for you. I see one academic search complete. I see two. Okay, I should see more than that. I want another one from Academic Search Complete. And you only italicize the name of the publication and Academic Search Complete. Okay, if you have any questions, let me know.